yourself with God's thinking. You've got to align yourself with God's thinking. You've got to become intuitive to bring your mind to what the will of the Lord is. In fact, give me a Mark 8:33. I have this far in front of this piece of scripture about brotherhood. In order to do what God said when you don't want to, he said Jesus turned to look at the disciples. Get away from me, Satan. He said, you are sending merely from a point of view and not from God. So you've got to be careful to correct your view and your perspective of God. And understand that if God says it, he sees further than I do. It's not a matter of you knowing what God, understanding what God says. You got to know that God is a master planner. That God never intends for evil to come to you. Hallelujah. Emotions
I'm going to
Glory to God.
I
child right now because they don't know where they're going. They don't know what they're doing. But God said, I gave my life when I raised Christ from the dead. And it's only by God's grace that you will be saved. I decree my child will be saved. I decree my mate will be saved. I decree my business will be saved. I decree my home will be saved. Something intervene. Glory to God. Thank God for divine intervention right now. I'm feeling the Holy Spirit right now. I'm feeling the Holy Spirit. That breakdown you were supposed to have, you didn't have because I divinely intervened. Yeah. No, go Shabbat. Woo! That total demise of everything you worked for, you didn't lose because I divinely intervened. You don't know what God is doing, but you know He's doing something. And you have a figure for what He's doing right now. Because something supernatural is happening for you while you walk away from God's perspective and then you will be to be fulfilling.
Real quick, changer. You got to cry for your children right now, right now. Lift your boy up close. Come on, son. Come on, Zion. Help this man. Lift your boy up close.
The my child, you can't do the funeral or do anything until the state coroner does his examination. But they were trying to find what they were trying to find what happened. And they found nothing.
So Balaam went on with Balaam's official. Now, that is all.
almost as if we went back to point one. No, we actually did not. What God decided was, I got to lead him out of this mess he's in. Did you hear me? I got to lead him out of this mess he's in. So God says this, God says, rather than kill you, I lead you. Y'all made some stupid mistakes and some stupid decisions, and you're stuck there. And the decision, the mistake can kill you on its own. But God said, I ain't gonna kill you. I'm gonna lead you. I will lead you. God says, I will lead you. Psalm 37:23, I want you to say this and mean in your heart. The Bible says, the Lord directs the steps of a godly, of the godly. The reason why I use the New Living Translation, because it said the steps of a good man. And then the Bible says, ain't none good but the Father. Well, if you think about what good means, the word good means God. It's a euphemism for God. So God directs the steps of the godly. I want you to say that God is directing my steps. You're not denying that you sin. You're not denying that you messed up. You're not denying that you didn't want to, but because of who you are with God, when you confess your sins, he said, it's business as usual. Oh, glory to God. I'm going to get you out of this. He directs the steps of the godly. He delights in every detail of the life. So even in this situation, that could have been tragic for me. Thank you.